Hello again, Musashi. Let's Players. Welcome to Let's Play Brave Fencer Musashi for PS1. This game was released by Squaresoft in 98, and it's a pretty interesting game where you play the role of Brave Fencer Musashi, summoned by the all-you-can-eat Princess Filet, in an attempt to thwart off the invasion of the Thirst Quencher Empire. So let's watch the opening cutscene and see what this is all about. This game is pretty neat. It actually featured some interesting voice acting and quite clever storyline. It's very satirical. Pretty fun to play. Some say it's a lot like Zelda.
There does be no effect.
Not exactly, but...
They shall find us our whereabouts soon.
They always talk funny. It's
they were waiting for the king's absence to attack.
Livers.
Like, why is the Bicho type so large? Does this mean?
Like, why do you talk
so
large?
It is eminently necessary that you perform Hero Summon.
Do it.
Oh, we can finally meet him, the lovely and handsome Brave Fencer Musashi.
Princess, please resume your assignment.
Here goes nothing.
Gracious hero, Brave Fencer Musashi.
He's rather small.
Now they're all disappointing.
This will not do.
It must have been too large of a task for the princess.
Hey, wait! Like, do you think I'd actually make a mistake? Have you guys seen the real Sir Musashi?
No, we haven't.
Ain't it?
Then maybe the real Sir Musashi is this puny little thing.
Not very nice. Haven't even started playing, and already we're off to a terrible start. Insults.
Who did you say was puny? And why are you guys wearing such stupid costumes?
Yeah, shut up.
Stupid costumes? Take that back, you little turd!
Please, princess.
Nice.
A little turd.
Hostility.
Calm it down.
Love it. I love it.
The name's Musashi, you geezer.
Yeah.
Pardon
right.
Me. We doth have a request for thou, Sir Musashi.
Doth hath with hath?
You're not serious, are you? It's too much of a chore for this little lad.
If
figure
the
it
princess
out.
Summoneth him, he must doth be a credible hero.
What do you guys want? Let me go home. I'm busy, you know? Can someone get me a Blandwin?
You've been summoned to save our world, so you can't go back to your world until you save ours. Isn't it just a shame? And you will remain in this world until the absorbed Bincho energy from the summoning disappears.
What do you mean I have to save this world? And I'll die if that what's it energy disappears? Ha!
There doth not be enough time. You must immediately head forthwith to Spiral Tower.
They would definitely be prowling about the area looking for Lumina. Thus, please take this with you. It's called Fusion.
Hey, pretty cool looking sword.
Fusion has surpassingly miraculous powers.
That's a pretty interesting weapon.
When it pierces an enemy, it absorbs.
You get to use two weapons in this game, actually. One is Fusion, and one is the Sword of Musashi that we have to go obtain as our first quest.
It's called Assimilate.
Assimilate? Sounds cool. Thanks, pal. It'll come in handy. By the way, what's this huge sheet? And this note?
That's Lumina's sheet.
We find it.
We want you to go to Spiral Tower, which is like right behind the castle. The Sword of Luminescence, Lumina, is on the roof. That note will show you how to get there.
It's that simple.
Okay,
really.
So I need to get Lumina, right?
That's right. Our world can have peace when we have Lumina and the five scrolls. And if you're the real Musashi, you can get Lumina. We're counting on you, you know? Huh? Ripson? Where's Musashi?
Trying to get it done.
He doth be waked, Princess. Impatient doth he be.
That's gonna get old fast. The journey begins. Let's get going.
Shoot! Why do I have to do this? What the?
Musashi's actually voiced by a woman.
Then I'm out of here.
So the controls are pretty simple. You have your jump, you have your attack, and then soon we'll learn how to use some of the other special abilities. It plays kind of like Zelda and Secret of Mana together. Throw enemies at other creatures and it'll cause extra damage. Those green blobs fill up your Bincho power, which is used for using special abilities and magic later on. And then the coins they drop are obviously your money. You guys out. The game will get more difficult later, but just rock. We're gonna get a log pushed down the hill here, so let's see if we can jump it. No, we missed. It moves pretty quick, so we got shot. And it hurts a lot. Quack! So now here we're going to learn how to use Assimilate.
Shoot! It's too far to jump.
Huh? Standing 2 feet away, hey, and he can't even hit us.
I'll use Fusion to get his abilities!
Said, so hold R1 button until the gauge is full, and that's the gauge down in the left corner. And then push square to throw it when it is full. And then push square rapidly to assimilate his powers. Don't fill it up in time, you'll still obtain Bincho power, so that's like the key, kind of. Let's fill this up, well this guy can't hit us. Okay, do it properly, I'll throw my sword and simulate gunshot. Telekinetic bullets.
What a cinch! I'll use gunshot to hit those logs, and...
basically, we'll just fire. Took a little more than usual, but that's okay. Come on! Like a slam shot right there, I like that. Music in this game is pretty neat too. They actually made a second one, a sequel to this game, for the PS2. I think probably about 2 years ago. I actually didn't prefer it to this one.
But where's the tower?
It may beg to differ.
Where's that note I got at the castle? Let's see. The path will not open unless you sacrifice a warrior. Maybe those statues have something to do with it.
So this statue will attempt to zap us with that red explodey stuff. Basically, you just move whenever it comes down. And then break these statues and that'll open the way.
Hey! Something's under this statue! Give it a stomp!
So that ominous statue head will come into play a little later. So do this for the last two statues. Come on, stand on it. Alright, and this will raise the tower. Now we get to climb that. Super. Okay, so it's about time to cut off now, and when we return, we will climb Spiral Tower and get Lumina. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned.